those fuddies by the end of this project,
I'm gonna be more beautiful than both of them. Come on.
That sounds very difficult.
Okay, so this is about my experience I had shopping for makeup at CVS on Main Street to become the woman that you saw in the other video. Hopefully you watched that first. I went shopping with Michelle Lee, who's a 12, Hillary Nguyen, who's a 12, and Hector Lopez, who's a 12. They're all 12s, considering the fact it's all sophomore summer. But, okay, so we drove down to CVS, and it was an experience. There's a lot more to makeup than I thought. I thought makeup was literally like, you put it on, you buy it, and you go. But there's a lot more involved in that. Like, we ran into some of the issues just shopping for the time we did, which was about 10, 15, 20 minutes. The first issue we really ran into was the fact that for people of my complexion, my dark skin, there isn't very many makeup products for us, because in societal views, my dark skin isn't really that beautiful, so people aren't really making makeup for us. I almost ended up having to get like anti-age foundation because they couldn't find any foundation that would work with my face. And I was just kind of shocked at the fact that even makeup perpetuates this idea that like dark skin isn't beautiful. What else happened? First of all, makeup is really confusing. I don't know what any of it is. You can see in the video that I'm just kind of like following these girls around. They're handing me products. I'm taking them because I have no clue what else to do with them. They did a really good job in the videos, you can see, of making me look natural and not like a clown, as they said when we were shopping. But the stuff's really also really expensive. Like, I'll run a credit of how much all this is at the end, but it was about $70, and we were shopping pretty low end at this point because I didn't want to spend this much money on stuff that I'd only use a few times. But even shopping at the low end and stuff that I guess is really unhealthy for your face, we still spent about $70 for what the girls said they would use in one day. And this is my day look, according to them. Apparently there's a day and a night look, and what I bought was just a day look, and it's about $70. So makeup's also really expensive. So at the end, like, women have to spend so much more money just to be beautiful than men do. And that's true, because they're also spending more on their clothes, most likely, and their purses and their shoes. So just in general, women have to put out so much more cash in order to be beautiful in society's terms than men do, because men can throw on jeans or khakis or whatever they want and be a bro and don't have to worry about matching or anything along those lines. And it's just kind of unfair in that sense that women have to do so much more work just to be beautiful. But yeah, there was a, what else happened? I was called a shemale by one of my friends when I told them what I was doing for this project. I was insulted numerous times by close friends, and I think they were joking, but it just kind of goes to show you that like gender, like who you identify with as your gender and how you choose to express yourself still really matters. But that was my makeup experience. I'm gonna go. Yeah, that was that. Cool. Alright, so I'm not sure how these people are gonna take this, but we're gonna try and tell them that this is for me.
You can
see their facial reactions.
But you should also ask if she minds us having a camera in her face right now.
Because
why don't I just have a conversation with you being like, well, I think this will be really good for
your skin. Yeah, and we'll see how they like react. Alright, it's a stage. We'll see how this goes.
This is so awkward.
Okay. How about a CVS card? I do have a telephone. It's
941-942-9229.
That's the one. I'm really excited for the shimmer.
Yep.
Fantastic.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Great. I'm fucked up! If you're not drunk, ladies and gentlemen!